To language now, as Aotearoa affirms one of its official languages in Te Wiki o Te Reo Māori, Tangata Pacifika reports on one of the least heard Pacific languages from the small island of Rotuma. There's a small community in New Zealand, and as Lisa Tauma reports, they're doing what they can to keep their language alive.
You leave your culture behind, you go to a new place. How do you keep that alive?
There's a complicated language.
The language is very important to us, yeah.
In the outer reaches of Polynesia lies a little island north of Fiji called Rotuma. Strictly speaking, it's in Melanesia, but the people are of Polynesian descent. This tiny island's population mostly migrates to Fiji. However, there are about 300 Rotumans living in New Zealand, whose language, like many other small island groups, is struggling to survive. Sophia Tikala-Smith spent 13 years growing up on her mother's island, where Rotuman was her first language. But she struggles with trying to give her New Zealand-born children some sense of their island ancestry.
I remember the first time I hadn't spoken the language for 17 years, and I turned up, found my family, and couldn't understand a word, even though that was my first language. I could not understand a word that they were saying after 17 years of not hearing it. We're too small to have, you know, we can't have like a kohanga reo or we can't have an aonga. You know, there's no like Rotuman nest. The only way for my kids to be able to speak Rotuman is for me to keep going back home and keep telling people to speak to them in Rotuman.
All the new migrants to New Zealand, the young ones, they can speak Rotuman fluent. It's only our New Zealand-born that we are concerned that they learn how to speak and learn our culture at the same time. This is why we have our church services in Rotuman.
The language is a linguistic rarity, full of apostrophes, J's and double consonants. It doesn't resemble any of its fluid vowel-speaking Pacific cousins.
There are some words in Rotuman that are quite unique, that don't seem to have cognates in other closely related or nearby languages. So the Rotuman language is something of a puzzle for linguists.
The speaking is not so bad, but it's only the ones that really educated from Rotuma that comes here that they can write properly.
With church, I think the music and singing, using the language through hymns, prayer and all that kind of thing helps. There's 11 different ways of saying one particular vowel, and so actually being able to see it written as well as spoken is quite important.
For Sophia, the culture and language from the tiny island she was brought up on is glimpsed only occasionally in Auckland.
Once a year I go to Pacifica and I meet all the Rotumans and I listen to the Rotuman being spoken and I eat the fiké and I look at the Rotuman, the way that we interact with each other. What else is there in New Zealand for us?
Well, that's a good question, and I think that's a plight for all our small islands languages. So to all our Rotuman people, nō ia e Māori.